All right, as mentioned, we're going to welcome Weedghost to the Creekside stage. There's so many new names to get used to. So the Creekside stage for the Sycamore Sessions. Please welcome Andrew Lampela and Kris Poland. Yeah. And I'm going to sit. Yeah. All right, you got your mic?
Yes.
Wonderful. All right, so here's the first thing I want to just quickly talk about.
Does this...
Are we good?
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. So as Brian mentioned... Correct me if I'm wrong, but like 2008, you have opened or performed at the festival for the last 14, well, minus the pandemic years, but since 2008.
Sounds right to me.
So can you maybe walk us through a little bit of that history, what that trajectory has looked like from the first year through now, what you've experienced?
Yeah, well, we used to play on the very corner of the main stage in between the two headliners. And then we moved to the cabin, which I think suited us a little better. It was my favorite story of the main stage was the year that we set up, played, and were breaking down our gear, and the sound guy finally came over and was like, "All right, what am I miking?" I was like, "All right, cool." It was neat, though.
Yeah.
Just the little corner of the crowd got us.
Yeah, so you're referring to the No-Fi cabin at the old property.
Yeah.
So, give us some, like, when you all were there, how your sound has developed kind of in and through those years of performing there.
Well, the no electricity kind of got us, since everything is electric. So we just found battery-powered stuff and kind of had to wing it. It was neat. That was such a cool spot to see things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So in terms of the overall sound, can you talk about, like, influences? I mean, you all have been around in the Athens music scene, I think, around the invention of the internet in that?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So going back a little bit, and a lot of iterations of the music scene here as well. So how did this kind of come out of all the other great projects and bands that you have been involved with? Kris, you can pass the mic as well if you want.
Yeah. Well, we were in a band called the Arch Villains. It was two basses and drums, and before every show, we would just make some noise before the drummer came up. And one day, at a show in Columbus, the drummer from Nelsonville Music Fest alumni, I, came up to us and was like, "Man, that stuff was cooler than your band. You should just do that and call yourself Weedghost." So we did. And here we are. And I think pretty early on we just figured out that, as you will see this weekend, there are billions of people that can write a song better than us. So we just decided to get weird with it.
Kris, you want anything?
I think you pretty well
got it. Okay. Agreement. So, yeah, and I think that this new stage as well is really amenable to...
Oh, yeah, this is going to be awesome.
Yeah, yeah, I'm excited. Well, we're thrilled to have you christen the new location. I think this is a moment in Nelsonville Music Festival history, which will be remembered for
thrilled
sure, is when we
here.
All where it all started all over again.
This is one of the best weekends out of the year, every year, so. And this is a beautiful spot.
That's right.
And we're going to ruin it.
Oh, it's going to be wonderful.
Have fun.
All right, an apt introduction. So please join me in welcoming Weedghost to the Creekside stage.